ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदामेयं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुर्वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथामृतं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सगणललिता श्रीविशाखामृतांश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नाम्नि नमस्ते सारस्वते देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशकारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे कृष्णा। आप सभी का स्वागत है आज के सेशन में जिसका नाम है श्रील प्रभुपाद की पुस्तकाएं। आज हम पढ़ रहे हैं जन्म और मृत्यु से परे, बियॉन्ड बर्थ एंड डेथ। मैं स्क्रीन शेयर कर देता हूं। आज हम पढ़ेंगे सेकंड चैप्टर, जिसका नाम है एलिवेशन टू एट दैट, मतलब मृत्यु से क्या होगा। देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ ट्रांसेंडेंटलिस्ट्स हु आर कॉल्ड योगीज, हठ योगीस, ज्ञान योगीस, ध्यान योगीस एंड भक्ति योगीस, एंड ऑल ऑफ देम आर एलिजिबल टू बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड। द वर्ड योगा मीन्स टू लिंक अप, एंड द योगा सिस्टम आर मेंट टू एनेबल अस टू लिंक विद द ट्रांसेंडेंटल वर्ल्ड। एज मेंशन्ड इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, ओरिजिनली वी आर ऑल कनेक्टेड टू द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, बट नाउ वी हैव बीन अफेक्टेड बाय मटेरियल कंटेमिनेशन। द प्रोसेस इज दैट वी हैव टू रिटर्न टू द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड, एंड दैट प्रोसेस ऑफ लिंकिंग अप इज कॉल्ड योगा। Another meaning of the word yoga is plus. At the present moment, we are minus God or minus the Supreme. बहुत important point है, plus और minus के बारे में बता रहा है। At present moment, we are minus God or minus of the Supreme. When we add Krishna or God to our lives, this human form of life becomes perfect. At the time of death, we have to finish that process of perfection. During our lifetime, we have to participate the method of approaching that perfection, so that at the time of death, when we have to give up this material body, the perfection can be realized. Prayana kale manasa chalena bhaktya yukta yoga balena chaiva bruvor madhye pranam avishyam samyat satam param purusham upeyati divyam. One who at the time of death fixes his life here between the eyebrows or in full devotion engages himself in remembering the Supreme Lord will certainly attain to the Supreme Personality of God at Gita 8.10. Just as a student studies a subject for 4 or 5 years and then takes his examination and receives a degree, similarly with the subject of life, if we practice during our lives or the examination at the time of death, and if we pass the examination, we are transferred to the spiritual world. Our whole life is examined at the time of death. यम यम वापि स्मरण भवम त्यजते अन्ते कलेवरम तम तम एव इति कौन्तेय सदा तद भाव भाविता। वॉट एवर स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग वन रिमेंबर्स व्हेन ही क्विट्स हिज बॉडी, दैट स्टेट ही विल अटेन विदाउट फेल। भगवद गीता 8.6। देयर इज अ बंगाली प्रोवर्ब दैट सेज दैट वॉट एवर वन डज फॉर परफेक्शन विल बी टेस्टेड एट द टाइम ऑफ हिज डेथ। इन भगवद गीता कृष्णा डिस्क्राइब्स वॉट वन शुड डू व्हेन गिविंग अप द बॉडी। For the Dhyan Yogi, Shri Krishna speaks the following verses. Yad aksharam veda vido vadanti visanti yad yatato vitaraga yad icchanto brahmacharya charanti tattet padam sangrena pravakshay sarvadhava dhvarani samyamya manohridi nirukhyacha mrudhyani adhayatmanah param asit Asthito yoga dharanam. Persons learned in the Vedas who utter Omkara and who are great sages in the renounced order enter into Brahman. Desiring such perfection, one practices celibacy. I shall now explain to you this process by which one may attain salvation. The yogic situation is that of detachment from all sensual engagements, closing all the doors of the senses and fixing the mind on the heart and the life air at the top of the head, one establishes himself in yoga. Bhagavad Gita 8.11 and 1.2. In the yoga system, this process is called pratyahar, which means just the opposite. Although during life the eyes are engaged in seeing worldly beauty, at death one has to retract the senses from their objects and see the beauty within. Similarly, the ears are accustomed to hearing so many sounds in the world, but at the moment of death, one has to hear the transcendental Omkara from within. Om iti kaksharam brahma vyaharan mama anushmaran yah prayati pyajam deham sayati paramam gatim. After being situated in this yoga practice and vibrating the sacred syllable Om, the supreme combination of letters, if one thinks of the supreme personality of Godhead with his body, he will certainly reach the spiritual planets. Bhagavad Gita 8.13. In this way, all the senses have to be stopped in their external activities and concentrated on the form of Vishnumurti, the form of God. The mind is very turbulent, but it has to be fixed on the Lord in the heart. When the mind is fixed within the heart and the life air is transferred to the top of the head, one can attain perfection in life. At this point, the yogi determines where he is to go. In the material universe, there are innumerable planets, and beyond this universe, there is the spiritual universe. The yogis have information of these places from Vedic literatures. Just as one going to America can get some idea of what the country is like by reading books, one can also have knowledge of the spiritual planets by reading Vedic literatures. The yogi knows all these descriptions and he can transfer himself to any planet he likes without the help of spaceships. Space travels by mechanical means is not the accepted process for elevations to other planets. Perhaps with a great deal of time, effort and money, a few men may be able to reach other planets by material means, spaceships, spaceships, etc. But this is a very cumbersome and impractical method. In any case, it is not possible to go beyond the material universe by mechanical means. The generally accepted method for transferal of to higher planets is the practice of the meditational yoga system or Gyan system. The bhakti yoga system, however, is not to be practiced for transferal to any material planet. For those who are servants of Krishna, the Supreme Lord, are not interested in any planets in this material world because they know that on whatever planet one enters in the material sky, the four principles of birth, old age, disease, and death are present. On higher planets, the duration of life may be longer than on this earth, but death is nonetheless. By material universe, that we refer to those people with to those planets where birth, old age, disease, and death reside. And by spiritual universe, we refer to those planets where there is no birth, old age, disease, and death. Those who are intelligent do not try to elevate themselves to any planet within the material universe. If one tries to enter higher planets by mechanical means, instead death is assured, for the body cannot stand the radical changes in atmosphere. But if one attempts to go to higher planets by means of the yoga system, he will acquire a suitable body for entrance. We can see this demonstrated on this earth, for we know it is not possible for us to live in the sea in a watery atmosphere, nor it is possible for aquatics to live on the earth. As we understand that even on this planet, one has to have a particular type of body to live in a particular place. So a particular type of body is required for other planets. On the higher planets, bodies live much longer than on Earth. For 6 months of Earth is equal to 1 day on the higher planets. Thus, the Vedas describe that those who live on higher planets live upward to 10,000 Earth years. Yet despite such a long lifespan, death awaits everyone. If one lives 20,000 or 50,000 or even million of years in the material world, the years are all counted and the death is there. How can we escape this subjugation by death? Both important point. In material world, the years are all counted and the death is there. How can we escape this subjugation by death? That is the lesson of Bhagavad Gita. Na jayate mriyate va kadachin नायं भूत्वा भावितावान् न भूय अजो नित्य शाश्वत तोयं पुराणो न अन्यते अन्यमाने शरीरे. फॉर द सोल देर इज नेवर बर्थ नॉर डेथ नॉर वंस हैविंग बीन Does he ever cease to be? He is unborn, eternal, ever existing, undying, and permeable. He is not slain when the body is slain. हरे कृष्णा, यहाँ से कंटिन्यू करना चाहेंगे. हमारे साथ हैं सौरभ प्रभु, प्रदोष प्रभु. कौन कर रहे हैं?
जी आई कैन कंटिन्यू.
थैंक यू.
ओके, वी आर स्पिरिट सोल एंड सच वी आर एंड एज सच वी आर इटर्नल. व्हाई देन शुड वी सब्जेक्ट आवरसेल्व्स टू बर्थ एंड डेथ? One who asks this question is to be considered intelligent. Those who are Krishna conscious are very intelligent because they are not interested in gaining entrance to any planet where there is death. They will reject the long duration of life in order to attain a body like God's. Ishwara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha. Sat means eternal, Chit means full of knowledge, and Anand means full of pleasure. Krishna is a reservoir of all pleasure. If we transfer ourselves from this body into the spiritual world, either to Krishna Lok, Krishna's planet, or any other planet, spiritual planet, we will receive a similar Satchidananda body. Thus, the aim of those who are in Krishna consciousness is different from those who are trying to promote themselves to higher planets within this material world. The self or soul of the individual is a minute spiritual spark. The perfection of yoga lies in the transfer of the spiritual spark to the top of the head. Having attained this, the yogi can transfer himself to any planet in this material world according to his desire. If the yogi is curious to know what the moon is like, he can transfer himself there. Or if he is interested in higher planets, he can transfer himself there. Just as travelers go to New York, Canada, or other cities on the earth, wherever one goes on earth, he finds the same visa and customs system operating. And all the material planets, one can, and on all the material planets, one can similarly see the principles of birth, old age, disease, and death operating. Om iti ekasharam brahma. At the point of death, the yogi can pronounce Om Omkara, the conscience form of transcendental sound vibration. If the yogi can vibrate this sound and at the time remember Krishna or Vishnu, mam Anushmaran, he attains the highest goal. It is a process of yoga to concentrate the mind on Vishnu. The impersonalists imagine some form of the Supreme Lord, but the personalists do not imagine this. They actually see. Whether one imagines him or actually sees him, one has to concentrate his mind on the personal form of Krishna. Ananya Cheta Sata Satatam Yomam Smarati Nityasha Tashyaham Shulabha Partha Nitya Yuktashya Yogina. For one who remembers me without devotion, I am easy to obtain, O son of Partha, because of his constant engagement in devotional service. Bhagavad Gita 8.14. Those who are satisfied with temporary life, temporary pleasure, and temporary facilities are not to be considered intelligent, at least not according to Bhagavad Gita. According to the Gita, one whose brain substance is very small is interested in temporary things. We are eternal, so why should we be interested in temporary things? No one wants a non-permanent situation. If we are living in an apartment and the landlord asks us to vacate, we are sorry, but we are not sorry if we move into a better apartment. It is our nature, because we are permanent, to want a permanent residence. We don't wish to die, because in actuality, we are permanent. Nor do we want to grow old or to be diseased, because these are all external or non-permanent states. Although we are not meant to suffer from fever, sometimes fever comes and we have to take precautions and remedies to get well again. Fourfold miseries are like a fever, and they are all due to the material body. If somehow we can get out of the material body, we can escape the miseries that are integral with it. For the impersonalists, to get out of this temporary body, Krishna here advises that they vibrate the syllable Om. In this way, they can be assured of transmigration into the spiritual world. However, although they may enter the spiritual world, they cannot enter into any of the planets there. They remain outside in the Brahmajyoti. The Brahmajyoti may be compared to the sunshine, and the spiritual planets may be compared to the sun itself. The spiritual sky, the impersonal lights, remain in the effulgence of the Supreme Lord, the Brahmajyoti. The impersonalists are placed in the Brahmajyoti as spiritual sparks, and in this way, the Brahmajyoti is filled with spiritual spark. This is what is meant by merging into the spiritual existence. It should not be considered that one merges into the Brahmajyoti in the sense of becoming one with it. The individuality of the spiritual spark is retained, but because the impersonalists do not want to take a personal form, he is found as a spiritual spark in the effulgence. Just as the sunshine is composed of so many atomic particles, so the Brahmajyoti is composed of so many spiritual sparks. However, as living entities, we want enjoyment. Being in itself is not enough. We want bliss, anand, and well, as being sat. In his entirety, the living entity is composed of three qualities: eternality, knowledge, and bliss. Those who enter impersonally on the Brahmajyoti can remain there for some time in full knowledge that they are now merged homogeneously with Brahman. But they cannot have the eternal ananda bliss because the part is wanting. One may remain alone in a room for some time and may enjoy himself by reading a book or engaging in some thought. But it is not possible to remain in that room for years and years at a time, and certainly not for all eternity. Therefore, one who merges impersonally into the existence of the Supreme, there is very chance of falling down again into the immaterial world in order to acquire some associate. This is the verdict of Srimad Bhagavatam. Astronauts may travel thousands and thousands of miles, but if they do not find rest on some planet, they have to return again to Earth. In any case, rest is required. In the impersonal form, rest is uncertain. Therefore, Srimad Bhagavatam says that even after so much endeavor, if the impersonalists enter into the spiritual world and acquires an impersonal form, he returns again into the material world because of neglecting to serve the Supreme Lord in love and devotion. As long as we are here on earth, we must learn to practice true love and serve Krishna, the Supreme Lord. If we learn this, we can enter into those spiritual planets. The impersonalist's position in the spiritual world is non-permanent. For out of loneliness, he will attempt to acquire some association because he does not associate personally with the Supreme Lord. He has to return again to the world and associate with conditioned living entities there. It is of utmost importance, therefore, that we know the nature of our constitutional position. We want eternity, complete knowledge, and also pleasure. When we are left alone for a long time in the impersonal Brahmajyoti, we cannot have pleasure. And therefore, we accept the pleasure given by the material world. But in Krishna consciousness, real pleasure is enjoyed. In the material world, it is generally accepted that the highest pleasure is sex. This is a perverted reflection of the sex pleasure in the spiritual world, the pleasure of association with Krishna. But we should not think that the pleasure there is like the sex pleasure in the material world. No, it is different. But unless sex life is there in the spiritual world, it cannot be reflected here. Here it is simply a perverted reflection, but the actual life is there in Krishna, who is full of all pleasure. Therefore, the best process is to train ourselves now so that at the time of death, we may transfer ourselves to the spiritual universe, to Krishna Loka, and there associate with Krishna. In Brahma Samhita, Sri Krishna and his abode are described thus: Chintamani Prakara Sadmashu Kalpa Vriksha Taktashvritshu Shurabhir Abhipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Sata Samrama Shayana Mana Govindam Adipurushan Tam Aham Bhajami. I worship Govinda, the primeval lord, the first progenitor who is tending the cows, fulfilling all desire in abodes built within with spiritual gems, surrounded by millions of wish-fulfilling trees, always served with great reverence and affection by hundreds and thousands of Lakshmis or Gopis. This is a description of Krishna Lok. The houses are made of what is called touchstone. Whatever touchstone touches immediately turns into gold. The trees are wish-fulfilling trees or desire trees, for one can receive from them whatever he wishes. In this world, we get mangoes from mango trees and apple from apple trees. But there from any tree, one can get whatever he desires. Similarly, the cows are called Suravi and they yield an endless supply of milk. There are descriptions of spiritual planets found in Vedic scriptures. In this material world, we have become acclimatized to birth, death, and all sorts of suffering. Material scientists have discovered many facilities for sense enjoyment and destruction, but they have discovered no solution to the problems of old age, disease, and death. They cannot make any machine that will check death, old age, or disease. We can manufacture something that will accelerate death, but nothing that will stop death. Those who are intelligent, however, are not concerned with the fourfold miseries of material life, but the elevation to the spiritual planets. One who is continuously in trance does not divert his attention to anything else. He is actually situated in trance. His mind is always filled with the thought of Krishna without deviation, ananya cheta satatam. Satatam refers to anywhere and anytime. In India, I lived in Vrindavan and now I live in America. But this does not mean that I am out of Vrindavan. Because if I think of Krishna always, then I am always in Vrindavan, regardless of the material designation. Krishna consciousness means that one always lives with Krishna on the spiritual planet Golok Vrindavan, and that one is simply waiting to give up this material body. Smarati Nityasha means controlling, continuously remembering. And for one who is continuously remembering Krishna, the Lord becomes Tashyaham Shulabham, easily purchased. Krishna himself says that he is easily purchased by this Bhakti Yoga process. Then why should we take to any other process? They can chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, 24 hours daily. There are no rules and regulations. One can chant in the street, in the subway, or at his home or office. There is no tax and no expense, so why not take to it? Hare Krishna.
Jai. So, what are the learnings?
इसमें तो पहली बात तो उन्होंने जिस तरह से डिस्क्रिप्शन दिया है कि कैसे इम्पर्सनलिस्ट को पीस नहीं मिलता है वहां पे, इवन दो दे मर्ज इनटू द ब्रह्म ज्योति, दे आर स्टिल हैंकरिंग फॉर सम काइंड ऑफ एसोसिएशन, बट सिंस उनका एलिवेशन उतना स्ट्रांग नहीं है, कॉन्शियसनेस स्ट्रांग नहीं है, दे अगेन कम बैक टू मटेरियल वर्ल्ड, एंड इसीलिए फिर उनको स्टार्टिंग से ही जितना भी प्रोग्रेस था सब लूज हो जाता
है. इवन आफ्टर अटेनिंग स्पिरिचुअल प्लैनेट्स वन मे गेट बैक टू द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड. हमको समझना चाहिए जब हम स्पिरिचुअल प्लैनेट की बात करते हैं इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वो भोले वृंदावन चले गए. जस्ट अबव द देवी धाम द ब्रह्म ज्योति इज अंडर द स्पिरिचुअल अबोर्ड, तो उसके ऊपर महेश धाम, हरिधाम, देन भोले वृंदावन. तो जो इम्पर्सनलिस्ट होते हैं दे अटेन ब्रह्म ज्योति and they are ekdam, you know, quarantine ki tarah se ekdam chup baithe rehte hain because they have nothing to do there. Kyunki wo nirakar brahma ko ki upasna karte hain. Nirakar matlab na aakar hai, na sound hai, na kuch hai, kuch bhi nahi hai, just a void kind of. So that is what is wrong with them. Acha, and bhagwan ke dham ke bare mein kya bataya gaya hai?
Desire trees and touchstone, like everything that you touch turns to gold, and the trees are wish fulfilling. Aisa nahi hai ki ek ped se ek hi cheez mil payegi, it can fulfill all your needs. And the cows are like kya word tha,
chintamani prakarsa satmashu kalpa vriksha, लक्षावृतेषु शुरभिरपि पालयन्तं लक्ष्मी सहस्र सत संभ्रम सेवयानं गोविंदमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि। भवने चिंतामणि प्रकर्ष सद्मशु कल्प वृक्ष, चिंतामणि जैसा धाम है जहां पे कल्प वृक्ष है। कल्प वृक्ष मतलब यू इमेजिन समथिंग एंड दैट कम आउट कम्स आउट। अगर आप एक पेड़ को देख के बोल रहे हैं मुझे जैसे आम चाहिए, मैंगो, सडनली एप्पल आ गया, गोल्ड आ गया, वॉट एवर यू विश इट कम्स। सुरभीर गाय, यहाँ पर गाय आजकल दूध नहीं देती है, देयर द काउस गिव गोल्ड डायमंड्स जेम्स ज्वेल्स। ओके तो क्या बोल रहे हैं, लक्ष्मी सहस लाइक थाउजेंड्स ऑफ लक्ष्मी इज सर्विंग नारायण देयर एंड क्या गोविंद आदि पुरुषम तमाम भजेंगे, ऐसे भगवान की मैं प्रार्थना करती हूँ, गोविंद आदि पुरुषम तमाम भजेंगे। Such is the abode of Lord.
एक डिस्क्रिप्शन ऐसा भी आता है ना कि वहां पे लाइक इवन वॉकिंग इज लाइक डांसिंग एंड लाइक एवरी वॉइस इज अ मेलोडी।
वॉकिंग इज लाइक डांसिंग ऐसा नहीं आता है वहां पे, इट इज सेड दैट पीपल डजंट वॉक दे ओनली डांस, दे डजंट टॉक दे ओनली सिंग। व्हाई? बिकॉज़ वी आर इन फुल एक्सटेसी। चैतन्य महाप्रभु व्हाट ही यूज्ड टू डू, ही यूज्ड टू जंप लाइक एनीथिंग, ही यूज्ड टू सिंग लाइक एनीथिंग, ही यूज्ड टू क्राई लाइक एनीथिंग। क्यों? क्योंकि When we are like जो जनरल एग्जाम्पल देते हैं प्रभुपाद, मान लीजिए आपको 1 करोड़ रुपए की लॉटरी लग गई, तो आप अगर किसी को बताने जा रहे हैं तो आप मधुर स्वर में गा गा के नाच नाच के उस चीज को बताएंगे कि मेरे को 1 करोड़ की लॉटरी मिल गई। दैट इज वॉट इज द सिचुएशन देयर वेर देर इज एटर्नल ब्लिस। सो वेन वी आर एटर्नल ब्लिसफुल देन वॉट एवर वी स्पीक दैट कम्स आउट एज अ यू नो सॉन्ग, वॉट द मूवमेंट दैट वी डू दैट इज डांसिंग इन इट सेल्फ। And there we get a Satchit Anand Vigraha, the body that is made up of Satchit Anand. And this is a very simple and very important verse. If we can try to remember this, this says about the soul. Like this is something which Krishna uses in the second chapter to cut the argument of Arjuna regarding the, you know, compassion. Arjuna kehte hain ki mere Bhishma Pitama, Dronacharya, Kripacharya aur इतने वरिष्ठ वैष्णव, मतलब मेरे परिवार संबंधी सगे गुरु ये लोग जो मर जाएंगे तो ये तो बहुत बुरी बात है। तो उस समय कृष्ण कहते हैं, न जायते मृत्ये वा कदाचिन नयम भवितान प्रिय अजो नित्य शाश्वतो यम पुराणो न हन्यते। मतलब तुम किसको मारने की बात कर रहे हो? जो आत्मा जिसने वो शरीर धारण किया है, ना तो उसका कभी जन्म हुआ था ना उसकी मृत्यु होगी, और शरीर की कुछ भी हो जाने से वो कुछ उसका कुछ भी हानि नहीं होती है, ऐसा कह करके वो अर्जुन को समझाते हैं। और बहुत सारे आर्ग्यूमेंट्स अर्जुन देते हैं और सारे आर्ग्यूमेंट्स को खंडन करके फिर महाभारत का युद्ध शुरू होता है। दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। इसमें बताया गया है कि वॉट एवर विल बी आर कॉन्शियसनेस ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ डेथ द सेम बॉडी विल अटेन। इसलिए कई बार कहा जाता है कि अगर अगर जिंदगी भर हम लोग व्यापार या पैसे या घर परिवार सुख समृद्धि जिसके बारे में भी चिंता करेंगे, हाउ कैन वी थिंक ऑफ कि एंड मोमेंट में हमको भगवान का स्मरण आएगा। फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, हम लोग दिन भर कोई मान लीजिए अचानक से कुछ बुरा हो गया आपके साथ, तो अगर आप दिन भर उसका चिंता करते हैं तो रात को आपको उसी को लेकर के सपने आते हैं। इट इज वेरी कॉमन कि वॉट एवर यू थिंक इन द एंटायर डे जनरली इट कम्स इनटू योर ड्रीम। सो वॉट एवर इफ यू contemplate throughout your life, whatever it is, 60, 70, 80 years, whatever it is. So how can you expect that something, you know, that is very different to it comes to the moment, end moment when it is required. और इसमें प्रभुपाद बताया ना कि हम 4-5 साल पढ़ते हैं डिग्री लेने के लिए, एग्जाम देने के लिए, वैसे ही हम ये जिंदगी पूरी केवल इसीलिए जीते हैं एंड मोमेंट में अंतकाले नारायण स्मृति। ठीक है, अगर कोई बोलता है कि अभी तो जीने को मिला है, जीना चाहिए, जी के सब ऐश करने के बाद देखा जाएगा जो होगा, तो देख जब जी लेते हैं, ऐश कर लेते हैं, सब कुछ खत्म हो जाता है, उसके बाद जब दुख आते हैं इस जन्म में अगले जन्म में, तब उसको हम एक्सेप्ट भी नहीं कर पाते, उसको एक्सेप्ट करना चाहिए हैप्पीली। इसीलिए वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर। ऐसा कहा जाता है कि एक व्यक्ति जितना इंटेलिजेंट है उतना दूर का देख सकता है, और जो जितने दूर का देख सकता है उतनी अच्छी प्लानिंग कर सकता है, उसकी उतनी प्लानिंग होती है। फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, अगर एक बच्चा अभी ना एक बच्चा बोल रहा हूँ मान लीजिए हम अभी ग्रेजुएशन में पढ़ रहे हैं और ग्रेजुएशन में पढ़ के हम अगर नौकरी तक की हेल्प प्लानिंग करेंगे तो हम नौकरी पाने के बाद क्या करना है नहीं समझ पाएंगे। अगर हम नौकरी के बाद शादी तक की प्लानिंग करेंगे तो नौकरी कर लेंगे, शादी हो जाएगी, शादी के बाद क्या करना है वी डोंट नो। फिर नौकरी, शादी, बच्चे तक की प्लानिंग कर लें, बच्चे के बाद क्या करना है पता नहीं। फिर हम रिटायरमेंट तक की प्लानिंग कर सकते हैं। अब रिटायरमेंट तक की प्लानिंग हुई उसके बाद क्या करना है वी डोंट नो। इसीलिए जो जितना दूर का देख सकता है, जैसे इसमें और एक एग्जाम्पल आता है ग्रास ओपर का और आंट का। ग्रास ओपर सीज की अभी तो बहुत बढ़िया मौसम चल रहा है, लेट अस एंजॉय। लेकिन जो आंट है उसको पता है कि बाद में जाकर के ठंड आने वाली है, आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू गेट फूड। तो क्योंकि वो दूर का देख पा रही है तो शी प्लान्स अकॉर्डिंगली, और जो ग्रास ओपर नहीं देख पा रहा है ही प्लान्स अकॉर्डिंगली। इसी प्रकार से कोई हमको अगर बोलता है कि पहले इस जन्म का देखो तो इस जन्म का तो दिख ही रहा है, चल ही रहा है, और इस जन्म को सही तो प्रिपेयर करना है अगला जन्म। अब एग्जाम वाले दिन जब एग्जाम हॉल में बैठेंगे तब तो तैयारी नहीं कर सकते ना, तैयारी पहले से करके जानी पड़ेगी। राइट, दैट इज ऑल अबाउट कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस। ऑल राइट, तो और कोई कुछ कहना चाहते प्रदोष प्रभु अपन की चुकाई पे?
ରହୁଛି ମୁଁ ପଚାରୁଥିଲି କି ଯୋଉ ଆମେ ଓମ ଓମ ଶବ୍ଦ କହୁଛେ ସେଟା ଭଗବାନଙ୍କ ସହିତ କଣ ଲିଙ୍କ ରହୁଛି ଓମ ଶବ୍ଦରେ?
କୃଷ୍ଣ ଗୀତାରେ କୁହନ୍ତି ମୁଁ ସବୁ ଧ୍ୱନିରେ ଓମ, ସିଲେବଲ ଯେତେ ଯାକ ସିଲେବଲ ରହୁଛି ସବୁ ସିଲେବଲରେ ମୁଁ ହଉଛି ଓମ, ଆଉ ଓମ ଭିତରେ ସବୁ ଯାକ ବଢେ ଆସେ। ଆଉ ଓମ ଗୋଟେ ବୀଜ, ଓମ ଓମକୁ ବୀଜ କୁହନ୍ତି, ବୀଜରେ ତା ଭିତରେ ମିନିଟା ମୁଁ ଭୁଲି ଯାଇଛି ଏବେ ମନକୁ ଆସୁନି, କିନ୍ତୁ ଭଗବାନ ଗୀତାରେ
जो अबे जोगी माने सब ओंकार को ये करके से माने टॉप टॉप मोस्ट लेवल जो गोलक को जाई पर ना दे से माने ब्रह्म सत्य रह जा जंदी से माने ओम।
हां कौन तो से माने
कौन तो सेटा मो क्वेश्चन से
ना तो से तो बोलती ना ओम भगवान को जंदी, भगवान ध्वनि रे ओम रोई जंदी, तो से माने कौन कर जंदी ध्वनि माध्यम रे भगवान को जाने का चेष्टा कर जंदी। ठीक अछि, किंतु भगवान रो गोटे रूप रही छि, ভগবান গোটে ফর্ম রয়েছে, তো যেহেতু সে ফর্ম কু চিন্তা করে পার না, সে কেবল তার সাউন্ড কু চিন্তা করছেন, তো সেথিপাই সে যেহেতু ভগবান কু চিন্তা করছেন তো সে ম্যাটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড কু ক্রস করে যাই পারছেন, কিন্তু যোটা চিন্তা করছেন সেতে যাই যাবে না। যদি আপন কম কইবে যেতে 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 আপন চিন্তা করিবে সেটাই তো আপন পাইবে। যদি আপন গোটে মাটি ধরিবে ସେ ମାଟି ଧରିକି ଆପଣ ଭାବିବେ କି ମୁଁ ସେଠି ଗୋଟେ ସାଇଣ୍ଟ ସ୍କ୍ରିପ୍ଚର ବନେଇବି, ସ୍କଲ୍ପଚର ଆପଣ ବନେଇ ପାରିବେ। ଆଉ ଆପଣ ଖାଲି ଧରିକି ହାତରେ ସେଟାକୁ ପାଣିରେ ପକେଇବି କି ମୁଁ ଗୋଟେ ବକ୍ସରେ ପକେଇବି, ଯୋଉ ଆପଣ ସେପ୍ ଦେବା ଦେବେ ସେଟା ହବ। ତ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କ ଗୋଟେ ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ରହିଛି, ଯୋଉ ସାଉଣ୍ଡରେ ଭଗବାନ ନିଜେ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ସେମାନେ ସେଟାକୁ ଚିନ୍ତା କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ତ ବ୍ରହ୍ମ ଜ୍ୟୋତିରେ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି। ଆଉ ଭକ୍ତ ମାନେ ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଫର୍ମ ତାଙ୍କର ରହିଛି, ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଜାଗାରେ ରୁହନ୍ତି, ଭଗବାନ ଏମିତି ଦେଖାଯାଆନ୍ତି, ଏମିତି ତାଙ୍କ ଲୀଳା ରହିଛି, ଏ ପ୍ରକାର ତାଙ୍କର ସବୁ କର୍ମ ରହିଛି, ସେଟା ଯିଏ ଚିନ୍ତା କରିପାରେ ସେ ଭଗବାନ ପାଖକୁ ଯିବ। ଯିଏ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କ ସେବା କରିବା ଚାହୁଁଛି ସେ ଭଗବାନ ପାଖକୁ ଯିବ। ଆଉ ଯିଏ ଭାବୁଛି କି ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଧ୍ୱନି ମାତ୍ର, କି ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଲାଇଟ, କି ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଏନର୍ଜି, ତ ସେ ସେଇ ପାଖକୁ ଯିବ। କାହିଁକି ନା ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମକୁ ଲାଗୁଛି କି ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଏନର୍ଜି, ଆଉ ଆମକୁ ଭଗବାନ ସାକ୍ଷାତ ଆସିକି କହିବେ ମୁଁ ଭଗବାନ, ତମେ ବିଶ୍ୱାସ କରିପାରିବ ନା, କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମକୁ ଲାଗୁଛି ଭଗବାନ ଗୋଟେ ଏନର୍ଜି, ତ ଇଏ କେମିତି ଭଗବାନ ହେଇପାରିବେ? ତ ସେ ତ ଏନର୍ଜେଟିକ, ସେଥିପାଇଁ ଯିଏ ଯେତେ ଚିନ୍ତା କରେ ଭଗବାନ ଦିଅନ୍ତି। ଭଗବାନ ଗୀତାରେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ନା ଯିଏ ଯଥା ମାମ ପ୍ରପଦ୍ୟନ୍ତେ ତାମ ତଥୈବ ଭଜାମ୍ୟହମ୍, ଯିଏ ମୋ ପ୍ରତି ଯେତେ ଶରଣାଗତ ହୁଏ ମୁଁ ତାକୁ ସେତିକି ରିୱାର୍ଡ କରେ। ତ ଯିଏ ମୋ ମୋତେ ଯୋଉ ଭାବରେ ଦେଖିବାକୁ ଚାହେଁ ମୁଁ ତାକୁ ସେ ଭାବରେ ଦେଖାଯାଏ। ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ କେମିତି ଦେଖିବା, ବିଷ୍ଣୁ ପିତାମ ଚାହୁଁଥିଲେ କି ମୁଁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଦେହ ତ୍ୟାଗ କରିବି ସେ ସମୟରେ ମୋତେ କୃଷ୍ଣ ପାର୍ଥସାରଥି ରୂପରେ ଦେଖିବା ଚାହୁଁଛି। ଠିକ ଅଛି, ତ ଯେତେବେଳେ ପୁରା ମହାଭାରତ ଯୁଦ୍ଧଟା ସରିଯାଇଛି, ପାଣ୍ଡବ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ରାଜ୍ୟଟା ମିଳିଯାଇଛି, ସେ ସମୟରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ରାଜ୍ୟ କରିବା କଥା, କିନ୍ତୁ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଜାଣିଛନ୍ତି କି ଭୀଷ୍ମ ପିତାମ ଏବେ ଯାଏ ଦେହ ତ୍ୟାଗ କରିନାହାନ୍ତି, ସେ ଚାହୁଁଛନ୍ତି ମୁଁ ପାର୍ଥସାରଥି ରୂପରେ ଯାଉ। ସେ କଣ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ଯୁଧିଷ୍ଠିରଙ୍କ ହୃଦୟରେ ବସିକି ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ମତଲବ କନଫ୍ୟୁଜନ କ୍ରିଏଟ କରୁଛନ୍ତି କି ମୁଁ ଭୁଲ କଲି, ମୋତେ ଯୁଦ୍ଧ କରିବାର ନଥିଲା, ଇଏ ସେ ଦୁନିଆ କଥା। ତ ସେ କୃଷ୍ଣା ୟୁଧିଷ୍ଠିର ମହାରାଜକୁ, ଅର୍ଜୁନକୁ, ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ନେଇକି ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ଭୀଷ୍ମ ପିତାମ ପାଖକୁ। ସେ ଚାହିଁଲେ ନିଜେ ସଲ୍ଭ କରିପାରିଥାନ୍ତେ କିନ୍ତୁ ସେ କରିନାହାନ୍ତି, ସେ ଚାହିଁଥିଲେ ରଥ ଉପରେ ବସିକି ବି ତାଙ୍କ ସହିତ ଯାଇପାରିଥାନ୍ତି କିନ୍ତୁ ସେ ସେମିତି କରିନାହାନ୍ତି। ସେ କଣ କରିଛନ୍ତି, ସେ ରଥ ଚଲେଇକି ଅର୍ଜୁନକୁ ବସିକି ନେଇକି ଯାଇଛନ୍ତି। କାହିଁକି, କାହିଁକି ଭୀଷ୍ମ ପିତାମ ଚାହୁଁଛନ୍ତି କି ମୁଁ ପାର୍ଥସାରଥି ରୂପରେ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କୁ ଦେଖିକି ଦେହ ତ୍ୟାଗ କରିବି। ତ ସେଭଳିଆ ଆମେ ଯୋଉ ରୂପରେ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କୁ ଚାହୁଁଛୁ, ଯୋଉ ରୂପରେ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କୁ प्रार्थना करू जो कि पूजा करू सेवा करू से रूप से भगवान हमको आसी के दर्शन दान बुझि पाले हरे कृष्ण प्रभु बुझि पाले कि जी
हां प्रभु जी
अच्छा और सर
हां जी समझ
कौन कौन तो कौन तो
कि भगवान का अलग अलग डिफरेंट रूप रही से भीतर शब्द शब्द रूप भगवान का शब्द रूप गोटे ओंकार
हाँ
हाँ जे शब्द रूप को पूजा करुचे से तार लिमिटेशन अच्छे जे भगवान को डायरेक्ट भगवान का साकार रूप को पूजा करे पें जे तार एलिवेशन ता से उधर हवा
आगे आगे से तो मु भी कहू छी अब जेतु से शब्द रूप करी जे तो से गुटे जागा को जाई कि तारो किछ काम न दो जे मके आमे आबे भगवान को प्रेम रूप रे चाहू छी तो आमे जेतले गोलो बिना जे भगवान को सेवा करिवो से जेहेतु मटेरियल वर्ल्ड छाड़ दे जाय भी पारिवो तापर से कोन करिवो तू जानी नि ना से वंस पढ़े भी जीव तापर कौन करे तो ध्यान करुच ध्यान कर प्राप्त है ध्यान से ध्यान कर दरकार नहीं पहुंची गला कौन कर कि आम प्रोसेस कौन हुए एवं भगवान को ना नौ पर भगवान को ना नबु डिफरेन्स कौन हो प्रैक्टिसिंग स्टेज से समय परफेक्शन स्टेज नबु एवं नाम अपराध होते शुद्ध नाम हम बुझीपारे डिफरेन्स ठीक अच्छे अच्छा जय गुरु शिला प्रभुपाद की जय संवेद भक्त वृंद की जय गौर प्रेमानंदे।